Hello smart civil engineers, I'm engineer Masroor and you are watching your own YouTube channel Engineering Network. I'm back with another very interesting and important video. So in this video lecture, I will teach you guys about the basic difference between concrete and mortar. Now as we know that both concrete and mortar are very important construction materials used in any type of construction work, right? So it's very important for all civil engineers to know the basic difference between concrete and mortar. So I request all of you that please watch this video completely. Now before we start, if you find this video informative, then please like this video, share it, subscribe to my channel and also press the bell icon for more interesting civil engineering videos. So let's start. Okay, so the topic for today's video lecture is difference between concrete and mortar, right? So the first difference is their composition. Now if we talk about concrete, it is composed or made of sand or fine aggregate, cement, coarse aggregate and water, okay? Which means that if we mix these materials, then we will get a mixture which will be called as concrete. While on the other hand, the composition of mortar is little bit different than the concrete, okay? So the mortar is composed of sand, cement and water, right? So basically the main difference in composition of mortar and concrete is that in concrete we use coarse aggregate while in mortar we don't use any kind of coarse aggregate. Next difference is the function of concrete and mortar in the construction of building. Now concrete is used to take the load of the building, which means that concrete is used to make different structure elements like beam, column, slab and footing, right? So let's suppose I have a column right here as you can see on your screen and it is made of concrete, okay? Now when load is applied on this column, it will transfer the entire load to the next structure element. And it should be strong enough to transfer that load safely, right? While on the other hand, if we talk about the function or purpose of mortar in building construction, then mortar is used as a bonding material, which means that, let's suppose we have two layers of bricks right here, as you can see on your screen. Now in order to make a good connection between these two brick layers, we need a good quality mortar and it will be placed between these two brick layers, okay? So basically what I want to teach you guys here is the function or purpose of concrete is to make structure elements and transfer the load safely, while mortar is used to bond different brick layers, right? Next difference is the durability. So concrete is much more durable as compared to the mortar. Now here what is meant by durability? Well, it means that the lifespan or service life of concrete is much more longer than the mortar, okay? Next difference is water cement ratio. Now for concrete, we have to keep the water cement ratio much more lower because concrete is a structural material and it is used in the construction of beams, slab, column and footing, and all of them are structure elements. So basically, concrete is directly connected with the strength of the structure, right? So due to this reason, we have to keep the water cement ratio lower. While in case of mortar, the water cement ratio is higher because it is only a bonding material, and that's why we can keep the water cement ratio higher. But it has certain limits, so please keep those limits of water cement ratio in your mind for both concrete and mortar. Okay? Next difference is the lifespan of both concrete and mortar. Now, as we know, concrete is a structural material, so its lifespan or service life is much longer, almost more than 50 years, if it is mixed properly and used as per the standards. While in case of mortar, the lifespan or service life is around 25 to 30 years. Okay? But if both concrete and mortar is mixed and used according to the engineering standards, then it can last more than its service life. Right? So these are the basic difference between concrete and mortar. I hope you would find it informative. So please like this video, share it, subscribe to my channel, and also press the bell icon for more interesting civil engineering videos. See you guys in the next video.